वेलकम टू YouTube चैनल स्टूडेंट सक्सेस। अगर आप इस चैनल पे फर्स्ट टाइम विजिट कर रहे हो तो चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर लो और बेल आइकन को प्रेस कर लो ताकि हर नई आने वाली वीडियो की नोटिफिकेशन आपको मिलती रहे।
हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आवर YouTube चैनल स्टूडेंट सक्सेस। एज वी हैव स्टार्टेड चैप्टर 1 नंबर सिस्टम, आई हैव प्रोवाइड यू 2 वीडियो रिलेटेड टू दिस चैप्टर। This is third video on the number system. In this video, we will learn about operations on the real numbers. As we have known, combination of rational number and irrational number is a real number. So, operation that we will learn, that is how to perform addition, subtraction, multiplication and division on the real number. So our main motive is to know which operations can be performed on the real numbers. So very first is how to add 2 real numbers. First of all, we will learn about the sum of real numbers. So first point is the sum of rational and irrational number is irrational. That is, when we add rational and irrational number, we get a irrational number. Rational number means which we can write in the form of P over Q. For example, 2 by 3, 5 by 3, 5. And irrational number means a number which cannot be written in the form of P over Q, for example under root 2. So let us take an example. First is, we have to add 5 and under root 5. When we add 5 and under root 5, you know 5 is a rational number. 5 is a rational number and under root 5 is irrational number. When we add both 5 and under root 5, we get 5 plus under root 5. Remember one thing, we can add only like terms. Means if 5 is a rational number, it can be added into the rational number. It can be 5 plus 5 is equal to 10. But 5 plus under root 5 cannot be 10 because under root 5 is irrational number. So like terms can be added, but unlike term cannot be added. So 5 plus 5 is again a irrational number. The second property is the sum of 2 irrational number. When we add 2 irrational number, it may be a rational or irrational. First example is, if we add 5 plus under root 2. Now 5 plus under root 2 is a irrational number. And another is 5 minus under root 2. And 5 minus under root 2 is again a irrational number. When we add these 2 irrational number, here you can see 5 plus under root 2 is first irrational. 5 minus under root 2 is a second irrational. When we add them, now under root 2 and minus under root 2 both are like terms. So they will be cancelled out. Why they are cancelled out? One is sign is with positive and another is sign with negative. Positive negative will be cancelled out and we get only 5 plus 5 equals to 10, which is a rational number. So when we add 2 irrational number, we can get a rational number. जब हम 2 irrational numbers को add करते हैं, तो हमें rational number भी मिल सकता है और irrational number भी मिल सकता है. Second example is, when we add 2 irrational number, then the answer will be a irrational number. You can see here, 5 plus under root 2 is one irrational number. Second, 3 plus under root 2 is another irrational number when we add. Now again, I am repeating, only like terms will be added. 5 plus 3 is equal to 8 and under root 2 and under root 2. Here, this square root having coefficient will be 1. This is 1 under root 2 and this is 1 under root 2. 1 plus 1, 2, we will get 2 under root 2, which is again a irrational number. To summarize this, the sum of real numbers When we add rational number and irrational number, it may be a irrational number. And the second is when we add two irrational number, it may be a rational or irrational. The second is difference of the real number. When we add two rational numbers or when we add two irrational number and irrational number, what will be the result? We will see here. The first is the difference of the rational number and irrational number is a irrational number. Means जब हम किसी rational number को और irrational number को subtract करते हैं तो हमें क्या result मिलता है? That is a irrational number. Example is subtract 5 from 3 plus under root 2. Again, 5 is irrational number, 5 is rational number which can be written in the form of P over Q, and 3 plus under root 2 is a irrational number. It cannot be written in the form of P over Q. So when we subtract 3 plus under root 2, we get 3 plus under root 2 minus 5. Here 3 minus 5 will be minus 2 plus under root 2, which is a irrational number. Only under root 2 means like terms will be added to like terms and unlike terms will never be added. So under root 2, there is no another under root and there is no another number with square root, so it will be simply a under root 2 only. Okay, the second is when we subtract two irrational numbers, there it may be a rational number or irrational number. So first example is subtract 3 plus under root 2 from 3 minus under root 2. Both are irrational numbers. They cannot be written in the form of P over Q. So 3 minus under root 2 from 3 minus under root 2 will become first from. So 3 minus under root 2 will become first. Then after that minus 3 plus under root 2. There is a bracket. So sign inside the bracket will be changed. Now you will see 3 minus under root 2 will be as it is. This 3 you can see here. Here is a positive sign. When we open the bracket, it will be a negative. After that, this 2 under root 2 is with positive. When we open the bracket, it will be negative. So this 3 is positive, this 3 is negative, they will both cancel out and we will left with minus under root 2 and minus under root 2. And it is under root coefficient is minus 1, here is minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 2, we will left with minus 2 under root 2, which is again a irrational number. So second example is related to this. Subtract 4 plus under root 3 from 6 plus under root 3. Now 6 plus under root 3 will become first. After that minus, we have to subtract this bracket 4 plus under root 3. Again sign will be changed. 4 is with positive sign, it will be a negative. Then after that minus 3, and like term 6 minus 4 will be 2. And this is positive and this is negative sign. They both cancel out. We will only left with 2, and 2 is a rational number. To summarize it, the difference of real numbers is the difference of rational number and irrational number is again irrational number, and the difference of two irrational numbers may be a rational and irrational numbers. The next is product of real numbers. How to multiply two real numbers? So first is the product of rational number and irrational number is irrational. So example is multiply 5 by under root 2. 5 is rational under root 2 is irrational. When we multiply both, they we will get 5 under root 2. Now you see, you can't multiply 5 inside the under root. We cannot say it is under root 10. Only 5. Again, like terms will be multiplied. It is a rational, it is irrational. When we multiply, we get again a irrational number. The second property is the product of two irrational number may be irrational number or rational number. So first of all, multiply 5 under root 2 by 6 under root 2. 5 by under root 2 is also an irrational. 6 under root 2 is also irrational number. When we multiply both, 5 under root 2 multiply by 6 under root 2, 5 into 6, coefficient will be multiplied firstly. 5 into 6 is 30, and under root 2 multiply by under root 2, it will be a 2. 30 into 2 is equal to 60. Now remember one thing, when the both roots and numbers inside the roots are same, we get number itself. For example, it is under root 2 multiply by under root 2, it will be a 2. And for example, under root 3 multiply by under root 3, it will be a 3. Under root 4 multiply by under root 4, it is again 4. Means when the under roots number inside the roots are same, we get the same number, which is a, the 60 is a rational number. Again, when we multiply 3 under root 2 by 4 under root 3, what we get? 3 under root 2 multiply by 4 under root 3. 3 under root 2 multiply by 4 under root 3, we get 3 into 4, 12. Now you see, this under root 2 and this under root 3, they will both multiply. Again, these are like, these both are irrational numbers, so irrational number will be multiplied with each other. We get 2 into 3, 6. It equals to 12 under root 6. Here I have explained you, under root 2 multiply by under root 3, when we combine it, the whole under root equals 2 multiply by 3 is equal to 6, which is again a irrational number. So properties are, for the real numbers, product, the product of rational number and irrational number is irrational. After that, the product of two irrational numbers may be a irrational or rational number. After that, the last operation is division. How to perform the division on the real number? When we divide a rational number and irrational number, again we get a irrational number. For example, if we divide 5 by 2 under root 2, that is 5 divided by 2 under root 2, we get 5 over 2 under root 2, which is again a irrational number. After that, the division of two irrational numbers. When we take two irrational numbers, they may be a rational or irrational number. So let us take an example to clarify this. Divide 2 under root 2 by 3 under root 2. 2 under root 2 divided by 3 under root 2. Now this under root 2 and this under root 2 will be cancelled out. We will only left with 2 under root 3, which is a rational number because it is written in the form of P over Q. After that, divide 8 under root 3 by 7 under root 2. You see, these both are irrational numbers which cannot be written in the form of P over Q. Now you see here, 8 under root 3 divided by 7 under root 2, we get 8 under root 3 by 7 under root 2, which is a irrational number. Now these are all about the operations of the real number. The next topic is some identities are relating to square roots. Some identities are relating to square roots have been given to you. For example, if you have under root AB, if you have under root AB, you can separate both in the different under roots. Under root AB we can write in the form of under root A and under root B. After that, this is in the form of product. After that, if we divide two numbers, under root A, square root of A and divided by B, then both square roots will be separated in the form of under root A divided by under root B. For example, if I say under root 6, 6 can be factorized in the form of 2 into 3. So it can be written as square root 2 into square root 3. Second example, if I take under root 5 divided by under root 5 divide 2, then it will be, it can be simplified as under root 5 divided by under root 2. And third identity is under root A minus under root B into under root A plus under root B. Here you see these A and A are same, B and B are same, only signs are different. The result only will be A minus B. Last is under root A plus under root B whole square equals to A plus 2 under root AB plus B. If there is a sign minus, then here in here we will replace this plus sign with negative sign. So these are the identities relating to the square root. After this, some examples are given to you. First example is, if under root 6 is here, we can factorize this 6 and it will be 2 under root 3. We will separate both under root 2 and under root 3. That means result is given here. Under root AB equals 2 under root A under root B. After that, second example is 3 plus under root 3, 3 minus under root 3. A plus B, A minus B equals to A square minus B square. So here A is 3 and B is under root 3. So identity will be A square minus B square. So here will be 3 square minus under root 3 square. It will be 3 square equals to 9 and under root 3 equals to 3. 9 minus 3 equals to 6. Here identity is given to you. Which identity I have used here? A plus under root B, A minus under root B. It will be A square minus B. After that, the next is, third example is under root 5 plus under root 2 whole square. Means A plus B here, whole square identity will be used here. It is A plus B whole square equals to A square plus 2AB plus B square. So under root 5 is A here and under root 2 is B here. So write in the form of A square plus 2AB plus B square, we get under root 5 whole square plus 2 multiplied by square root 5 multiplied square root 2 plus square root of 2 whole square. We'll get under root 5. Again, I have prepared under root 5. When we multiply 2 times, we get the same number. It is 5 plus 2 under root 5 plus into under root 2. We can combine it. The same result applicable here. If it is separate, we can write in the combined form. It will be 5 into 2 will be 10. It is 2 under root 10. After that, under root 2 will be, it is 2 times. So it will be 2. Like terms will be added. 5 plus 2 will be 7. And 2 under root 10 will never be added to 7. This, you have to remind this thing again and again. You keep it in mind. Okay, now we can add the rational number with the irrational number. We can simply write it. Okay. After that, another concept is on the real number is rationalization. Rationalization is another concept. What does it mean? Suppose we given a number whose denominator is irrational. Suppose it is 1 upon under root 2, 3 upon under root 5, 6 upon under root 5, any other number whose denominator is in the form of irrational number. So then this method rationalization is used. You see here, then the process of converting its denominator to a rational number by multiplying its numerator and denominator by the suitable number is called a rationalization. What does it mean? कि जब हमारे पास कोई नंबर ऐसा हो जिसके डिनोमिनेटर में कोई भी इरैशनल नंबर है, तो हमने उसे सिंप्लीफाई करने के लिए, कभी भी हमारे पास डिनोमिनेटर में इरैशनल नंबर नहीं होना चाहिए, तो उसे चेंज करने के लिए, उसे कन्वर्ट करने, सिंप्लीफाई करने के लिए हमें क्या करना होता है कि किसी ऐसे नंबर से हमें न्यूमरेटर और डिनोमिनेटर को डिवाइड करना होता है ताकि जो उसका डिनोमिनेटर है वो क्या बन जाए, रैशनल नंबर विदाउट स्क्वायर रूट बन जाए. ठीक है, फॉर एग्जांपल, फर्स्ट एग्जांपल आई हैव टेकन, रैशनलाइज द डिनोमिनेटर of 3 over under root 5. So here on converting, what we have to do on multiplying the numerator and denominator of the given number by 5, we get, what we have to do, we have to multiply 3 by under root 5 equals to, we will multiply and divide by under root 5. You see here, this here is under root 5. So how can we convert this under root 5 into a rational number? This thing you have to keep in mind, ki how we can convert this under root 5 into a rational number. So same number we will multiply with the square root. So here is under root 5, multiply and divide by under root 5. Again, under root 5 and under root 5, we get a 5, and in the denominator it will be 3 under root 5. Here this 5 is a rational number. Rationalization we use to make the denominator rational. So the next example is, rationalize the denominator of this given 1 upon 3 plus under root 2. Now here the operators are also will be there. It will be plus can be there. Here will be minus can. Minus will also be here. So for this, you have to keep in mind, when you have to multiply this, you have to rationalize. You will only change the sign. If it is plus, you will change the sign. Minus. Look at here. Multiply the numerator and denominator of the given number by 3 minus under root 2. 3 minus under root 2 you will multiply with the given number, with numerator and denominator, by 3 minus under root 2. Here we have 1 upon 3 plus under root 2 equals to 1 upon 3 plus under root 2, multiply and divide by 3 minus under root 2 upon 3 minus under root 2. Now you have to keep this sign in your mind. If it is plus, you will multiply and divide the same number, only you have to change the sign. Agar yahan par plus hai, to aapne jab bhi kisi number isse rationalize karna hai, to aapne kya karna hai, नंबर तो सेम रहेंगे, जस्ट यू हैव टू चेंज द ऑपरेटर. आपने प्लस है तो माइनस कर देना है, माइनस है तो प्लस कर देना है. नाउ 1 into 3 माइनस अंडर रूट 2 विल बी 3 माइनस अंडर रूट 2, एंड हियर 3 प्लस अंडर रूट 2 इंटू 3 माइनस अंडर रूट 2. हियर वी विल, दिस इज ए प्लस बी ए माइनस बी. Identity will be used here. It will be A minus B. a is here 3 and under root 2 is 2. So it will be under root, it will be 9 a square minus b square. So a square is a square 3, 3, 9 minus 2. It will be a 3 minus under root 2 is equal to 7. So here we see now the denominator become rational number. Now the next is how to represent a line under root 9.3 on the number line. First of all, for this you have to draw a line AB is equal to 9.3 unit. See here, first of all you have to draw a line AB is equal to 3 unit. After that, extend B to C as a 1 unit. You have to draw BC equals to 1 unit. After that, first you have to do this line AC. You have to draw the perpendicular bisector. For this perpendicular bisector gives you the midpoint of the line AC. How to draw the perpendicular bisector? Taking from here A, draw the arc here. After that, downward from C, draw the arc upward and downward. You will get a perpendicular bisector. This perpendicular bisector gives you a point O, which is the midpoint of the line AC. After that, O as a center and OA as a radius, draw a semicircle. Next step is what you have to do. You have to draw the BD perpendicular to the AC intersecting at the point D. Second, this BD will be equals to under root 9.3. After that, with B as a center, B as a center and BD as a radius, draw an arc. You have to draw an arc meeting point is AC at top, produced at a E. You have to draw an arc at a point E. This BE equals to 9.3. Again, I will repeat the steps. First of all, you have to draw a line AB equals to 9.3 units. After that, you have to extend C to the point such that BC equals to 1 unit. After that, you have to find the midpoint of the line AC. That is, you have to draw the perpendicular bisector of the line AC. After that, O, taking O as a center, draw a semicircle. Next, you have to draw the perpendicular to the perpendicular BD to AC intersecting at the point D. This BD will be equal to 9.3 unit. With B as a center and BD as a radius, draw an arc meeting AC at produced at E. Then this BE is equal to 9.3 unit. So in this session, what we have learned about operation on real numbers. We have learned about operations on real number, that is sum of real numbers. After difference of real number, product of real number, division of real number, identities relating to square roots, example related to identities, rationalization and some examples related to rationalization, and last is representing a real number, that is under root 9.3 on the number line.